Hello and welcome to the Bible with Briscoe 2020. I am your messenger of the Word of God, Shenandoah Briscoe. Today we are going to be covering Ezekiel 11 through 13 and James 1. Father, I just ask for clarity of voice so that the reading of your word will be a blessing to you and for those who have tuned in from all around the world. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And they all said, amen. God's sure judgment on Jerusalem. Then the Spirit lifted me up and brought me to the gate of the house of the Lord that faces east. There at the entrance of the gate were 25 men, and I saw among them Jezaniah, son of Azor, and Pelenteth, son of Benaiah, leaders of the people. The Lord said to me, Son of man, these are the men who are plotting evil and giving wicked advice in the city. They say, Haven't our houses been recently rebuilt? This city is a pot, and we are the meat in it. Therefore, prophesy against them. Prophesy, son of man. Then the Spirit of the Lord came on me, and he told me to say, This is what the Lord says. This is what you are saying, you leaders in Israel. But I know what is going through your minds. You have killed many people in this city and filled its streets with the dead. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. The bodies you have thrown there are the meat, and the city is the pot. But I will drive you out of it. You fear the sword, and the sword is what I will bring against you, declares the Sovereign Lord. I will drive you out of the city and deliver you into the hands of foreigners and inflict punishment on you. You will fall by the sword, and I will execute judgment on you at the borders of Israel. Then you will know that I am the Lord. This city will not be a pot for you, nor will you be the meat in it. I will execute judgment on you at the borders of Israel, and you will know that I am the Lord, for you have not followed my decrees or kept my laws, but have conformed to the standards of the nations around you. Now, as I was prophesying, Pelenteth, son of Benaiah, died. Then I fell face down and cried out to the Lord in a loud voice, Alas, Sovereign Lord, will you completely destroy the remnant of Israel? The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, the people of Jerusalem have said to your fellow exiles and all the other Israelites, They are far away from the Lord. This land was given to us as our possessions. Therefore I say, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Although I sent them far away among the nations and scattered them among the countries, yet for a little while I have been a sanctuary for them in the countries where they have gone. Therefore say, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. I will gather you from the nations and bring you back from the countries where you have been scattered. And I will give you back the land of Israel again. And they will return to it and remove all its vile images and detestable idols. I will give them an undivided heart and put a new spirit in them. I will remove from them their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. Then they will follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. They will be my people and I will be their God. But as for those whose hearts are devoted to their vile images and detestable idols, I will bring down on their own heads what they have done, declares the Sovereign Lord. Then the cherubim, with the wheels beside them, spread their wings, and the glory of the God of Israel was above me. The glory of the Lord went up from within the city and stopped above the mountain east of it. The Spirit lifted me up and brought me to the exiles in Babylonia, in the vision given by the Spirit of God. Then the vision I had sent seen when then the vision I had seen went up from me, and I told the exiles everything the Lord had shown me. The exiles symbolized Ezekiel 12. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, you are living among a rebellious people. They have eyes to see, but do not see, and ears to hear, but do not hear, for they are a rebellious people. Therefore, son of man, pack your belongings for exile, and in the daytime, as they watch, set out and go from where you are to another place. Perhaps they will understand, though they are a rebellious people. During the daytime, while they watch, bring out your belongings, packed for exile. Then in the evening, while they are watching, go out like those who go into exile. While they watch, dig through the wall and take your belongings out through it. Put them on your shoulder as they are watching, and carry them out at dusk. Cover your face so that you cannot see the land, for I have made you a sign to the Israelites. So I did as I was commanded. During the day I brought out my things, packed for exile. Then in the evening I dug through the wall with my hands. I took my belongings out at dusk, carrying them on my shoulders while they watched. In the morning the word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, did not the Israelites, the rebellious people, ask you, What are you doing? Say to them, This is what the sovereign Lord says, This prophecy concerning the prince in Jerusalem, and all the Israelites who are there, say to them, I am a sign to you. As I have done, so it will be done to them. They will go into exile as captives. The prince among them will put his things on his shoulders at dusk and leave, and a hole will be dug in the wall for him to go through. He will cover his face so that he cannot see the land. I will spread my net for him, and he will be caught in my snare. I will bring him to Babylonia and the land of the cauldrons, but he will not see it, and there he will die. I will scatter to the winds all those around him, his staff and all his troops, and I will pursue them with a drawn sword. They will know that I am the Lord, and when I disperse them among the nations and scatter them through the countries, but I will spare a few of them from the sword, famine, and plague, so that in the nations where they go, they may acknowledge all their detestable practices. Then they will know that I am the Lord. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, tremble as you eat your food, and shudder in fear as you drink your water. Say to the people of the land, This is what the sovereign Lord says about those living in Jerusalem and in the land of Israel. They will eat their food in anxiety and drink their water in despair, for their land will be stripped of everything in it because of the violence of all who live there. The inhabitant towns will be laid waste, and the land will be desolated. Then you will know that I am the Lord. There will be no delay. Ezekiel 12:21. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, what is this proverb you have in the land of Israel. The days go by and every vision comes to nothing. Say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. I am going to put an end to this proverb, and they will no longer quote in Israel. Say to them, the days are near when every vision will be fulfilled. For there will be no more false visions or flattering divinations among the people of Israel. But I, the Lord, will speak what I will, and it shall be fruitful. It shall be fulfilled without delay. For in your days, you rebellious people, I will fulfill whatever I say, declares the Sovereign Lord. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, the Israelites are saying, the visions he sees is from many years from now, and he prophesies about the distant future. Therefore say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says, none of my words will be delayed any longer. Whatever I say will be fulfilled, declares the Sovereign Lord. False prophets condemned. Ezekiel 13. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel who are now prophesying. Say to those who prophesy out of their own imagination, hear the words of the Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. Woe to the foolish prophet who follows their own spirit and have seen nothing. Your prophets, Israel, are like jackals among ruin. You have not gone up to the breaches in the wall to repair it for the people of Israel, so that it will stand firm in the battle on the day of the Lord. Their visions are false, and their divination is a lie. Even though the Lord has not seen them, and they say, the Lord declares, and expect him to fulfill their words. Have you not seen false visions and uttered lying divinations? When you say, the Lord declares, though I have not spoken? Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Because of your false words and lying visions, I am against you, declares the Sovereign Lord. My hands will be against the prophets who see false visions and utter lying divinations. They will not belong to the council of my people or be listed in the records of Israel, nor will they enter the land of Israel. Then you will know that I am the Lord, the Sovereign Lord. Because they lead my people astray, saying peace, when there is no peace, and because when a flimsy wall is built, they cover it with whitewash. Therefore, tell those who covered it with whitewash that it is going to fall. Rain will come in torrents, and I will send hailstorms, hurtling down, and violent winds, and burst forth. And when the wall collapses, will people not ask you, where is the whitewash you covered it with? Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. In my wrath, I will unleash a violent wind, and in my anguish, hailstones and torrents of rain will fall with destructive fury. I will tear down the wall you have covered with whitewash and will level it to the ground so that its foundation will be laid bare. When it falls, you will be destroyed in it, and you will know that I am the Lord. So I will pour out my wrath against the wall and against those who covered it with whitewash. I will say to you, the wall is gone, and so are those who whitewashed it. those prophets of Israel who prophesied to Jerusalem and saw visions of peace for her when there was no peace, declares the Sovereign Lord. Now, son of man, set your face against the daughters of your people, who prophesy out of their own imagination, prophesying against them, and say, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Woe to the woman who saw magic charms on, who sew magic charms on all of their wrists and make veils for various lengths for their heads in order to ensnare people. Will you ensnare the lives of the people but preserve your own? You have profaned me among my people for a few handfuls of barley and scraps of bread by lying to my people who listen to lies. You have killed those who should not have died and have spared those who should not have lived. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. I am against your magic charms, with which you ensnare people like birds, and I will tear them from your arms. I will set free the people that you ensnare like birds. I will tear off your veils and save my people from your hands, and they will no longer fall prey to your power. Then you will know that I am the Lord, because the disheartened, the righteousness with your lies, when I had brought them no grief, and because you encouraged the wicked not to turn from their evil ways and so save their lives. Therefore, you will no longer see a false vision or practice divination. I will save my people from your hands, and then you will know that I am the Lord. Okay, that was Ezekiel 11 through 13. Ezekiel does a lot of prophesying himself. I mean, not prophesying, but speaking. Whereas the Lord speaks also. Okay, how about James 1? James 1, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes scattered among the nations. Greetings, trials and temptations. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, wherever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. Believers in humble circumstances ought to take pride in their high position, but the rich should take pride in their humiliation, since they will pass away like a wild flower. For the sun rises with scorching heat and withers the plant. Its blossoms fall, and its beauty is destroyed in the same way. The rich will fade away, even while they go about their business. Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desire and enticed. Then, after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin, and sin, when it is full grown, gives birth to death. Don't be deceivers, and don't be deceived, my dear brothers and sisters. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. He chooses to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be a kind of first fruits of all he created. Lightning and doing. Listening and doing. James 1:19. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry, because human anger does not produce the righteousness that God desires. Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word planted in you, which can save you. Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Anyone who listens to the word but does not do what it says is like someone who looks at his face in the mirror, and after looking at himself goes away and immediately forgets what he looks like. But whoever looks intently into the perfect law that gives freedom and continues in it, not forgetting what they have heard, but doing it, they will be blessed in what they do. Those who consider themselves religious and yet do not keep a tight rein on their tongues deceive themselves and their religion as worthless. Religion that God our Father accepts is as pure and faultless, this is this: to look after orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world. There you have it. That was James 1. Okay, my friends, that looks like the end of the Bible with Briscoe 2020 for today. Tomorrow we will be covering Ezekiel 14 through 15 and James 2. Father, I thank you so very much for your word, because without your word, I could not be your messenger of the word of God, Shenandoah Briscoe. And so, with that being said, amen. And they all said, amen. All right, folks, that's been it for me, Shenandoah Briscoe, your messenger of the word of God. And I'd like to thank you for tuning in to the Bible with Briscoe 2020. And as always, you know, God loves you, and so do I. So come back and see me tomorrow, because, well, I'll be here, and I hope that you are too.